five things we learned in high school.
It's gonna be super chill. We have some snacks.
You know, I'll be the best.
And then some chips that I pretty much ate all of it already. So our first one that we have is branch out more.
You want to branch out, basically, like the thing said, and make new friends, because obviously in college, when your friends in high school, they'll go off to different colleges, and so obviously you have to make new friends, and the first friends that you meet on your freshman year of college, those are pretty much going to be your friends later in life. Mm-hmm. And maybe also some friends from high school will still be in contact with you, but you don't know for sure, obviously, for all of them.
Yeah. And I think it's just good to start making like connections and networking with other people than just your close friends, because like when you think about it, you're in your comfort zone when you're with all of your friends and that stuff. Mm-hmm. So like if you just take your time, like what I thought to do, and like I'm gonna do it more this year, is like find someone in the class who like I never really talked to, kind of just like someone that I've always known because they've been in my classes that I've never been friends with, and just like say hi to them. And just like try to make conversation with them, because you don't even know, like there can be so many more people that you can like be really good friends with. It's just that you've never taken the time. Yeah. Because you're always like, oh, I already have friends, like, how do I make more? But like, yeah, I think that's heck important.
Okay,
so our second one.
Go out more.
Because in high school, there's gonna be a lot of times where you just wanna like stay home and be like, I gotta study, I have to like do this test, I have to do all this homework. And you, maybe your friends invite you to go out and you're like, no, like I gotta stay home and like do all this stuff. But going out and like having fun with your friends and like, I mean, not just like going to parties, but like going to, out to eat and like go to the movies or whatever. Like, I think that's really important in order to take care of yourself. Like, you have to have fun too. You can't just be like so focused and not have a life outside of just doing your homework and like just doing like studying and all that stuff.
That would drive you crazy.
Yeah. And like, William. I'm an example of people who didn't really follow this. And like, we always were pretty much like indoors. Indoors and like, okay, we gotta study.
Yeah.
And like trying to focus on that stuff. But like, that's something that I think like both of us, right? Like a little bit like regret of being like not taking those opportunities when someone's like, oh, you wanna hang out? And we're just like,
no. Like, I'll pass this time, like, rain checked.
I wish I did, because you would have a lot more fun memories. Like, my memories are all like, oh yeah, when I was sitting at my desk and doing homework. That was a good time.
I always take pictures.
That's so important. There's a lot of time where, like, you want to look back and you want to see, like, all the stuff that you do. Like, but you shouldn't be so focused on trying to get, like spending all your time just taking pictures and not actually being in that moment. But having some pictures of like all those fun times when you're with your friends is really important, so that when you look back, oh, and you get collages, you can put it on your wall. Like, you see how blank this wall is? I should be putting pictures up there. Okay, so our third thing that we learned in high school is don't get caught up in relationships.
Correct. AKA drama, because you will be not destroyed, but well, I mean, you will learn a lesson from it, definitely.
Yeah, but because I feel like this, when people are in a relationship, they will be so focused on that person, and it will really distract.
No, what?
And it will really distract them from like doing their work and like paying attention in school. And I think like it's okay to have relationships, but you have to both be okay with being alone and like knowing like I gotta do my own thing sometimes. Because I see, like, I think we notice, like, don't you see a lot of couples or whatever, and it seems like they have to be together. And like when they're not together, they're just like, or like FaceTiming and they're like,
I also think it's because like how you guys are both seniors now. He's probably more focused on like college and stuff, and you too.
Well, especially for like relationships, when it comes to senior year, oh my god, this is the hard part. Okay, like I've seen people and I've known people who are just getting into relationships now while they're a senior, and that can be really hard because now you have to think about, oh snap, like I'm going off to like college or whatever, and it's like you don't want to have to make a decision based on the other person being like, oh, I wanted to go to like Berkeley or something, but since my boyfriend and girlfriend is going to like SoCal, I guess I'm gonna have to go there too. Like, you should make decisions based on yourself, which is why when you're in a relationship, sometimes it's like really hard not to, because you want to be with them and you're like, oh my god, I want to be with my boyfriend.
Long distance relationships are very hard to keep up with.
Yeah. It's like, it's hard enough, man. Like, sometimes in a regular relationship, but now long distance, you're just like, okay.
I mean, it's like you meet a new person, you're like.
Yeah, that's why I thought too. Because now you're separated and it's like you're having your own lives. So, I mean, like, it's whatever you guys want to do. But, like, that's something that I've definitely noticed. Like, it's really hard to be in a relationship, especially when you're, like, a senior and you're going to be separating pretty much. This one's for Vanessa because she knows this. And it's organization is key.
Because if you really have all your stuff together, you just pull it out. It's only, like, very, very specific things that I am very particular for. And that's just my schoolwork. Like, my school stuff, no one can touch that. Literally, no one can touch that. If you touch it, no.
Like, all the time growing up, like, I would always, like, I'd be like, and, like, poke her paper, and then she'd be like, or, like, any time when I accidentally, oh, yeah. Like, there was a time when I remember I was holding your notebook, and somehow the page bent. She literally just tore out the whole page, like, just start over, because it's like, no, like, she has to have
it's everything. It's ruined! It's not nice anymore.
But I think it's important because organization will carry with you throughout life. Like, in college, if you're not organized, like, what? You're gonna need that, because you have to, it's like, you're an adult now, like, you have to think about stuff like your financial aid, you gotta make sure you have all that paperwork.
Yeah.
You have to do, like,
oh my God,
scholarship stuff. You want to do study abroad, like all those things, like you need to be way more organized. You're gonna have a lot more responsibility than in high school. But then again, for high school, being organized makes everything easier. Like having a planner, man.
Yeah.
Oh my god, that is the most important. Yeah. This is my planner, and it is just super cute. Like, oh yes, honey. But it is so important because the planner makes it so that you have, like, everything written down, and you don't have to think, like, what was the homework, or, like, what's gonna be due on January 5th? Like, yeah. You have it all down, and you have, that's, like, one less thing to stress about. Because in high school, you're stressing about so many things. So, like, that shouldn't be something that you're worried about. And then organizing it makes it look nice. And to be honest,
it really does.
Aesthetics yes. is everything in high school. Yes. Oh, yeah, because if you do really good, and, like, make your stuff look super nice, and your teacher, like, grades like your binder, your notebook.
I love that.
You're probably gonna get 100% just because everything's neat. That's her. Okay, our last thing, which is really, really, really important, like just in general for everything, but for high school, it's a really good way to start it. And it's just like being nice to everyone and making sure you have like a good first impression.
Yes.
Being nice to everyone. It's because when you think about it, why spend like your days in high school just being like, oh, I'm gonna be all like cliquish and only be okay with my friend group, and everyone else is just like, oh, like, they're not worthy of my time.
Yeah.
Like, that's how some people are, and it's just like, why? And
so especially, you don't even know them. Like, you don't know the background, really.
Yeah, like, you don't know, like, what, okay, I know it sounds like super, like, cliche, but, like, you don't know what they've been through.
Yeah,
like,
really, that stuff. Though, really.
You don't. And so, it's like, being nice to everyone, it just makes it so
they feel better.
Yeah, like, they feel better, you feel better, and it makes everyone feel, like
positive, like, positivity. Mm-hmm. It spreads, like wildfire.
Yeah, like a positive wildfire.
But when you're born, the first thing you don't think of is to be mean.
Oh, that's so true.
Like you don't think of, okay, I'm gonna be mean to you. You're just like, okay, I met you.
Mm-hmm.
Let me get to know you.
Mm-hmm.
What do you like? What do I like? We'll connect.
Mm-hmm. And didn't even think of that. I didn't even think of that. You're not born to like hate someone.
Yeah.
You know. And I think like, being nice to people, it will carry on. Like, if you were nice to someone in high school, like, you don't even know what if that person is, like, someone super important someday. And it's just, like, they remember you, and they're like, hey, I remember you. And you're trying to get a job from them. Like, if you were their bully, they're gonna be like, hey there, Johnny. I remember you, Johnny. And then you're not gonna get a job.
Yeah.
But, like, if you're nice, they're gonna be like, oh, yeah, I know that person's reliable. And I think connections like that, honestly, are super, like, strong, and it makes it so people are like gonna trust you, because you know how like in professional environments, even though people have to like follow their like protocols and whatever, people are still gonna have like their bias because of the relationship they had with you. So if you were nice and you like were actually just like purely like really being compassionate towards them, they're gonna remember that, and that will, they'll probably like look at that more than just like, oh, I gotta follow the rules and like everyone has to be equal in like the job process or whatever. And then kind of with that is like having a good first impression.
Yeah. First impressions, positivity, they go together, and if you have a good first impression that is positive, then that will make, that's like, it's like basically implanted in the person's like brain, like, okay, at first I like met you, you seem cool, rather than you seem like you're a bad person, and but you're just like acting like you're nice or something like that, like afterwards.
Yeah.
Because you get something from them.
Yeah. I know that everyone, like, when you first meet someone, however they act, that stays in your brain. Like, if they were kind of mean, maybe they were having a bad day, but they were mean to you on that first time, you're just always gonna think that. And then, like what you're saying, how later on, if they tried to be nice, you're just gonna be like, like, I don't know, I remember you last time I met you. And so it's like, you just start off nice. So those are the 5 things that we learned in high school. I mean, we learned a lot more stuff, but like those are like the main ideas that are like, if you're like going into high school or you're in high school, you can like relate to or follow.
Yeah.
We hope you guys enjoyed our video.
Like, subscribe down below, and comment.
Yeah.
If you have any comments.
Yeah, if you're like, oh yeah, heck yeah, I agree with that, yeah. Do that. Okay, so we'll see you guys in another video.